All right, guys, welcome to your 19th Ruby lesson. And in this lesson, I'm going to talk to you guys a little bit more about numbers and teach you guys how to format numbers to give you guys the answer that you want. So let's go ahead and recap what we know already. We already know if we input something like 13 divided by 4, then Ruby's going to think that since we're asking it in integers, then we want an integer answer. So even though the answer to this question is 3.25, it's going to say, hey, 3. Close enough. You asked in integers, you want an integer. So we say, okay, now that we want the exact answer, let's just go ahead and do 13.0 divided by 4.0. Now whenever we ask it like this, it gives us the exact answer, 3.25. Why? Because we asked with floats or numbers with decimal points. But here's the thing. As the programmer, we know what's going on behind the scenes, and we know that we can kind of tweak Ruby and trick it into giving us the right answer. But say that we built this program, such as, you know, a simple calculator or something. Well, the user of that calculator doesn't know that you need to ask it numbers with decimal points. What they're going to do is they're going to, you know, maybe input a variable like 13 for A and 4 for B, and then they're going to go ahead and say, okay, print out A over B, and it's going to say 3. And they're going to say, hey, this freaking calculator is broken. What's wrong with this? Well, what we need to do whenever we're programming these things like simple calculators or anything, what we need to do is change the data type. We need to take their integers, and we need to change them into floats. So how do we do that? Well, in order to do that, we need to use a method called 2f. And this method pretty much takes an integer and it turns it into a float. So let's go ahead and run this baby again. So say that we made the same thing, like c equals, I'll use the same values, c equals 13 and b, or excuse me, d equals 4. Well, now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and print out the answer on the screen. But instead of just writing C over D, what we want to do is put C 2 underscore F. And whenever we do this, here's what's going on. It's going to freaking throat. Every time I'm doing these tutorials, my freaking throat dries out. What it's going to do is it's going to take C, which is 13, and it's going to call the method 2F. Now the method 2x takes the value, which is 13, and it changes it into a floating point number. So it's pretty much going to say, okay, this 13 is no longer an integer. It's now a float. So now whenever we try to print it out, Ruby knows that we want to work with floats. And the cool thing about this is basically the user can still input integers, but behind the scenes we're changing it to floats. So now with this technology we can build programs that are a lot more user friendly and a lot more precise. So let me go ahead and finish up this mini program. D2 underscore F. I always try to write tofu for some reason. So basically, even though the user inputted 13 and 4, what's really going on is we converted that to 13.0 and 4.0, and check it out. They now get the correct answer of 3.25, even though they asked it in integers. So there you go. That is how you take one data type and change it to another type of data. And by the way, this isn't the only method, 2F. There are different types of, well, I guess I might as well explain this. Whenever you change one data type to another data type in computer programming, it's called casting. So just remember that, and I'm just going to shut up and go get a drink of water or something, and I'll see you guys in the next video. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you then.